Warning, this experiment uses corrosive hydrochloric and nitric acids. Wear gloves when handling them. This experiment also generates hydrogen and nitrogen dioxide gases. Work outside or in a fume hood. Greetings, fellow nerds. It's been a while since we did something fun, so let's go and kill something with science. I've been given some old hard drives that need to be destroyed for security reasons. They're too old to be reused, so I thought I'd dunk them in acid. So here's the hard drive. I've taken the cover off so the acid has better access. First some water so the salts produced from the acid reaction will dissolve better. And now the acid itself, hydrochloric acid, also known as muriatic acid. And there we go. A hard drive is mostly aluminum metal, so the primary reaction is hydrochloric acid on aluminum, generating hydrogen gas and aluminum chloride. Of course, there are other metals, but aluminum is the main one. Okay, here we are an hour later. Let's check on the hard drive. Well, that's interesting. While the rest of the drive is badly etched, the platter still looks good. I'm going to leave it in for another hour. Now the platter is made of aluminum with an ultra-thin coat of magnetic alloy where the data is recorded. In some hard drives, the platter is made of glass or ceramic, but I'm pretty sure this particular platter is made of aluminum. The exact composition and structure of the magnetic coat changes as the technology evolves, but generally includes such elements as iron, chromium, cobalt, nickel, and even some precious metals like platinum and ruthenium. Whatever the exact alloy is, it's resisting hydrochloric acid. Now, before anyone has any ideas, the precious metals are not valuable as scrap. The coating is so thin as to be worthless. The aluminum platter itself and the case are worth more. Nonetheless, it is impressive that we can create a coating so perfect as to seal an aluminum platter against acid using just a few cents worth of extra metals. Okay, here we are another hour later. Well, the hard drive motor is completely gone. The drive casing is badly etched and would probably come apart if I used even more acid. But the platter is still intact. This is a major flaw with my plans for secure destruction considering the platter is the most important part of the drive. Of course, I'm not going to be defeated by hard drive platter, so let's step up our game to nitric acid. So here is the platter, and here is the nitric acid. Well, it looks like something is happening. The coating is dissolving and the metals are turning the acid solution green. The irony of using nitric acid though is that while it seems to be dissolving the coating, it won't dissolve the aluminum because aluminum develops a passivation layer of nitric acid that resists further attack. Of course, we can fix that easily enough by adding in hydrochloric acid to make aqua regia. There isn't much that can resist this stuff. Yeah, there we go. I think we can say the data is irretrievable now. And there you go, a hard drive in acid. Thanks for watching. If you would like to support the continued production of science videos like this one, please support the channel on Patreon. Links are in the video description.